the Rural Radio Network, I'm Shaylee Peters, and I have the pleasure of being able to visit today with Dr. Larry Cundiff. And you have spent a lot of time out here at the Research Center, is my understanding, and just briefly visiting with you. You are a retired scientist, but you still come out. Can you go into some of your background? We're celebrating 50 years here, and can you go into some of your background and work with the Research Center?
Yeah, I was fortunate to join the research programs here in January 1967, just when we were getting underway out here. And I was involved. First, I was located on the campus at the University of Nebraska for a half a dozen years until we got the facilities built here with a computer installed. I was always involved with the data analysis from the cattle breeding projects. And I moved out here then in 73 and have worked with my main project involved crossbreeding with beef cattle and then breed characterization. We characterized 37 different breeds over the years for traits that are important in beef production. And then we also looked at systems of crossbreeding to utilize those breed differences and the hybrid vigor among the breed crosses most effectively.
Okay, and today you will be speaking to all of the people here about some of the history with the Research Center. Can you go into some of what you'll be covering?
Well, just briefly, we'll mention that this was a naval ammunition depot. Like a lot of USDA research facilities, some of them occupy former military posts like the Fort Robinson Beef Cattle Research Station, which we closed and moved those cattle down here in the early 70s. When this one developed, this was a unique opportunity. It was a large land mass, 35,000 acres, and the ability to carry experimental populations of 7,000 cows, several thousand ewes, and 1,000 litters a year was what made this place unique over the years. And to be able to conduct experiments on a scale where you can really draw inferences to the beef industry or to the sheep industry or the swine industry is what's made this place unique. And it appeals to some of our best scientists have come here from around the country and are still here today.
Okay. And what, looking back on your time spent here and your service here, can you think of some of the highlights, some things that you really remember and have enjoyed in your service here?
Well, highlights in my exposure were the results of our cattle breeding projects and the impact they've had on the industry. When I first started working here, the cattle were all purebred or straightbred Herefords primarily and straightbred Angus. We learned that crossing breeds like Herefords, Angus, and Shorthorns increased productivity about 25%. Increased the herd life and longevity of the cows over a year and a third, and their lifetime production, and reduced the break-even cost of production 5 to 10%. Then we went on to characterize new breeds that were being introduced from Europe at that time, primarily because we thought they'd be larger and leaner. And as we'd shifted from finishing cattle on grass to feeding them in concentrate feedlots, feeding feed grains and feedlots, fatness had become a concern. And so they went to the leaner breeds, and the results did impact choice of breeds used in a beef industry. Some of the continental breeds like Charlet, Simmental, Limousine, Gelbwe came on to have a significant influence in our cattle industry and in crossbreeding systems. The British breeds still were important in our cow herds, the Angus, the Hereford, especially, as crossbreds. But the impact of that kind of work and then going on to the crossbreeding systems that we can use and the composite populations that we can use were the projects I was associated with that were most rewarding and had, we think, quite an impact and benefit to our industry.
What's your hope for the Research Center going into the future?
Well, I'm very excited about the young people we have on the staff here at the Meat Animal Research Center. The emphasis has shifted from the traditional approaches to cattle breeding to more emphasis on molecular genetics, to the basic sciences of molecular genetics, and a lot of our new scientists are involved in those kind of programs, not just as geneticists, but as physiologists and nutritionists and the biology of cattle, swine, and sheep production. But the young scientists we have working on problems like that are, I think, some of the brightest young people in the country, and we're fortunate that we've been able to attract them to come here to work.